Hi, welcome to automationtesting.in. In this video, we will see scenario or example in Cucumber. So what do you mean by scenario or example? Means scenario and example, both we can use for the same purpose. So we'll see what is scenario or example. So this is a concrete example that illustrates a business rule. It consists a list of steps. Means you have a feature. For that feature, we'll have a multiple scenarios. So scenario means it's a concrete example that illustrates a business rule. So what you are going to implement, right? For that, we'll have some steps for that. The keyword scenario is a synonym of the keyword example. So, right. So keyword scenario and keyword examples are used for same purpose. You can use scenario or example. So if you see any other blogs or videos, most of the times, 99%, people will use only scenario, not example. Okay, but you can use scenario or example for to describe scenario. You can have as many steps as you like, but Cucumber recommend you keep the number at 3 to 5 steps per scenario. If they become longer than that, they lose their expressive power as specification and documentation. So what Cucumber is suggesting that when you write any scenario or example, try to make sure that only put your business rule within 3 to 5 steps. Okay. If it is longer than that, you will lose your expressive power of that, what you are trying to express. But I don't think so that will possible for all the times. So all the scenarios, it might not possible. So, but Cucumber recommends that. Okay, just a theory. So we'll see one example how we can write a scenario once we look into the theory in detail. So in addition to begin being a specification and documentation, a scenario is also a test. As a whole, your scenarios are an executable specification of the system. Means in addition to being a specification or documentation, the purpose of writing this feature file is to express or to tell what the feature file is, right, in detail, without any confusion, all these things. And it will be useful as a documentation also. But along with that specification and documentation, a scenario is also a test. When it will become test? When you implement a BDD with Cucumber. Okay, so the topics which we are discussing, all these things are comes under BDD, right? So behavior driven development. But if you want to execute these feature files or these scenarios, so we will integrate Cucumber with this. When you integrate that, then these steps will become executable steps. Okay, that we will see in our upcoming videos. So examples follow this same pattern. Examples means the scenario. So describe an initial context. Right. So what you can see. So here when you see this, describe an initial context that is represented with given steps. The given is a keyword, and that will be used to describe an initial context. Okay, remember, given is for some predefined or given or initial context. And the same way, describe an event using when steps. When is also one of the keywords in feature file. And we can say the Kirkin language with given, when, then. Okay, when you use when, if you want to describe an event. Okay, and the same way, describe an expected outcome. Okay, so by using then steps. If you are using then, means you are expecting some outcome, some verification. Okay, so this is all about given, when, then. Given means initial context, when means some an event occurring or happening, and then means and verification point are expected outcome. Okay, you need to remember why we'll use given, what is the purpose of given, what is the purpose of when, and what is the purpose of then, all these things. Okay, so when you move next, so the steps, each step starts with given, when, then, and, or, but. So by using any one of these five keywords, your step will start. Given, when, then, and, or, but. Cucumber executes each step in a scenario one at a time. In the sequence, you have written them. Means you have written them in. When Cucumber tries to execute a step, it looks for a matching step definition to execute. Means how it will execute step by step, line by line, it will execute how you have written. To execute that, it needs a step definition. So what is step definition? We will see in our upcoming videos, but without step definition, you cannot execute. So the Gherkin feature file is a plain English. Plain English, you cannot execute. So the executable code, that means relevant executable code for each and every step, you will write in step definition file, okay? And keywords are not taken into account when looking for a step definition. Even though if you put given, when, then, and, or, but while executing, it will not consider those keywords, okay? So but step with the same text as another step, okay? This means you cannot have a given, when, then, and, but step with same text as another step. So anyhow, it is ignoring. Because of that, don't write all lines with the given, all lines with then, all lines with when, something like that. Okay, that's a very bad practice. There is no meaning of writing feature file. So Cucumber considers the following steps duplicates, right? So given, there is money in my account. Then there is money in my account. So, but that is given, this is then. Given means initial context, then means a verification point or something like that, your expected outcome. But here, as it ignores the keywords given and then the remaining is same, right? There is money in my account, there is money in my account, means both are duplicate, even though the keyword is different. Because of that, you should be very cautious while you're writing feature file. So this might seem like a limitation. You feel that's a limitation, but it forces you to come up with a less ambiguous, more clear domain language. So you feel that, you know, it's irritating. Like if whenever I write like this, it is considered as duplicate, but it forces you to come up with less ambiguous, means if you're not following that, you will write a good and clean domain language. Then you can easily understand, right? So instead of that, given there is money in my account, then there is money in my account. Instead of that, you can write like this. Given my account has a balance of 500 rupees, then my account should have a balance of 500 rupees, right? Both are different. Given is separate purpose, and then is separate purpose. Given means my account has already 500 rupees. Initial context is, it's like already it's there. Then what I can check? If I have a 500 rupees of balance, what you can check? You can check that whether 500 is there or not. Then my account should have a balance of 500. So if you write like this, it's more meaningful. Okay. So while writing, be careful, be cautious, write very clean and understandable feature files. Okay. If you go to next slide, so we'll talk about the given keyword. Given steps are used to describe the initial context of the system, the scene of the scenario. It is typically something that happened in the past, means already something is there. In the previous, we are saying that my account has a balance of 500, means it's already there in my account. So the same thing, initial context you are setting with this given. When Cucumber executes a given step, it will configure the system to be in a well-defined state, such as creating and configuring objects or adding data to a test database, right? So given means already well-known state. My account has 500 rupees. Already I known information, that is. right? So given is, the purpose of given is that. And the purpose of given steps is to put the system in known state before the user starts interacting with the system. Avoid talking about user interactions in givens. If you are creating use cases, givens would be your preconditions, right? The same thing, put the system into a known state, avoid talking about user interactions. For user interactions, what we discussed, when. So don't use that user interactions with the given keyword. Okay, given would be your precondition. It's okay to have several given steps. Just use and or but for number and upwards to make it more readable. Okay, so if you want to put some initial context with two lines, given this and given this, you can put like that. But instead of that, given this and this is a better combination or better way to do this. So examples taking Mickey and Minnie have started a game. I am logged in means these are not two given steps. Given means we already started a game. I already logged in. Something like that means the given is put your system into known state. Game started, already logged in, something like that. You can use for given keyword. And when steps are used to describe an event or an action. This can be a person interacting with the system, or it can be event triggered by another system. Means some actions are performing on your application or software. That can be a human or some other thing. Means with the automation tool, you are doing something, right? That is also possible. It is strongly recommended you only have a single when step per scenario. If you feel compelled to add more, it's usually a sign that you should split the scenario up into multiple scenarios. So as Kukumar is saying that recommended that use only one action in feature, means one scenario or example. If you want to more that, you just split that. I don't think so it is possible for all the scenarios, but it's a best practice if you follow the same thing. Okay. When guess a word, invite a friend, withdraw money, all these things are actions. Okay, these are examples. And then, right, then steps are used to describe an expected outcome or result. So when you're expecting something, that can be used with then steps. The step definition of a then step should use an assertion to compare the actual outcome to the expected outcome, right? Then step is to verify something. It's a verification point. When you talk about integrating with Cucumber or Selenium, then you need to write one assertion. Right, then means verification. How you achieve verification using assertions. So you need to write assertion in then step. An observation should be an observable output. That is something that comes out of the system, a report, user interface, message, and not something deeply buried inside it. Means when something happens, you should know what is happening. Okay, it should be like that. Some user interface action, or you can see some message on the application, something like that. Some of the examples are, see that the guessed words was wrong. Means it might be right or wrong. Some example, receive an invitation, card should be swallowed, something like that. While it might be tempting to implement then steps to just look in the database, resist that temptation, okay? So don't get into the deep that, look into the database, all these things. You should only verify outcome that is observable for the user. It's a best practice that it should be on your application itself, okay? And databases usually are not. But when it comes to the automation, we can do that also. But these are all theory that, you know, best practices. If you do like this, it's very effective way of implementing your BDD. Okay, all the things, all the theory may not possible in the real time. Okay, so that's all about the theory. Okay, we have seen that what is on a scenario and what is given, when, then all these things. So we'll try to write one sample scenario. Okay, so let's go to IntelliJ. So we already started writing this. Okay, so I will create one more feature file. I'll say something like cucumber knowledge dot feature, just an example. Okay, so here I need to write a feature. I'll say learn cucumber. Okay, so after that you can give a detailed description or not, that is up to you, but here that is not our intention. Our intention is scenario. So I'll put scenario. You see that scenario, and then you can give some description for scenario also. So getting cucumber knowledge, something like that. So till here we have seen. Now scenario will have steps. The steps will start with any one of the keywords like given, when, then, and but, right? So now I will start with given. You see that given is also in a blue color, means say predefined keyword. Given, I have a coworker who knows a lot about cucumber. It's a precondition, right? It's a precondition that I have a coworker who knows a lot about cucumber. Means it's already happened, past. He knows already. Because of that, I have given in means with given keyword. Then when, you see that is also blue color. When I ask my coworker to give an overview of how cucumber works, means something is happening. I'm asking something is happening, right? And then I'll say, if you want to use again, when I listen to their explanations, means I'm listening their explanations. This is also one of the actions. So that is the reason I put again, when. Given a coworker who knows a lot about cucumber, that is given. And I did two actions. One is I asked that guy, and I'm listening what he's explaining. Then what is the outcome of that? Then I should have a basic knowledge of cucumber. That is my outcome. Because of that, I'm writing with this verification with this then keyword, right? This is a sample scenario under a feature. So a feature file may have multiple scenarios. Okay, that we will see in our upcoming videos. But here, just an example that how a scenario we need to write or looks like. Scenario and some description about that, and given, precondition, when, some action, when, some action, then something, outcome came. Okay, so this is how you need to write a scenario. Okay, so that's all in this video. Thank you.